Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Mathematics Online class. In this class, we will be discussing a presentation on prisms and cylinder. This presentation mainly includes some formulas which are used to find the volume and surface area of prisms and cylinders. This will serve as a revision for you guys just to understand and remember the formulas which are involved in finding the surface area and volume of prisms and cylinder. So let's just get started. A prism is a 3D object, a three-dimensional solid that has two bases, or we can say that it has two identical shapes that are facing each other. These two identical shapes are called bases. These bases can be a triangle, a square, a rectangle, or any other polygon, but you have to be sure that the two identical bases or the two shapes which are identical should be parallel to each other, or we can say that they should face each other. The shapes other than the base of a prism can be a parallelogram or a rectangle. The basic difference between a prism and a pyramid is the bases. A prism has two polygonal bases and a pyramid has only one base and one top point, that is called the apex. The faces other than the base in a prism can be rectangular, it can be a rectangle, it can be a parallelogram, but in a pyramid the faces other than base will always be a triangle or a triangular faces. The similarity between a prism and pyramid is that both are polyhedrons and they both have polygon faces. They can't have circles since they are polyhedrons. So the first type of prism is a triangular prism, and as the name suggests, a prism that has a triangle as its base is called a triangular prism. And you can clearly see in the figure that there are two identical shapes, two identical triangles, one at the front side and one at the back side, and they both are facing each other, so these are the bases. And there is also the perimeter of the base means the sum of all the sides of a triangle. Since the base is a triangle, so the perimeter of the base will be the sum of all the sides of a triangle, and the length of the prism is the distance between the two identical faces. So moving forward with the formula of volume, we are always interested in finding out the volume and surface area of a triangular prism. So talking about the volume of triangular prism, the formula for the volume of triangular prism is base area multiplied by the length of the prism. Since the base of this triangle or prism is a triangle, so the base area means the area of the triangle, and multiply the length of the prism means the distance between the two identical faces, which is marked on the diagram, the length. And there is also a net diagram drawn of a triangular prism. Two faces are triangle, the front side and the back side, and two are rectangles. The surface area of a prism can be obtained by a formula: 2 times base area plus perimeter of base multiplied by the length of prism. 2 times base area means, since there are two triangles, so 2 times base area, 2 times the area of a triangle, plus perimeter of the base means, since it is a triangle, so sum of the three sides of a triangle will be the perimeter of the base, and length of the prism will be the distance between the two identical shapes. So these are the two formulas which you have to look very carefully. The volume of triangular prism is equal to base area multiplied by length of prism, and the surface area of a prism can be found out by the formula 2 times the base area plus perimeter of base multiplied by the length of prism. There is an example to find out the volume and surface area of a triangular prism. The dimensions of the triangular prism is, the length of the prism is 7. The base of the triangle is 5. The height of the base, that is the height of the triangle, is 4. And the two sides of the triangle is 7 and 9. So we have the length of the prism and we have the dimensions of the base. So first of all, we will be starting with the volume of triangular prism. The volume of triangular prism can be given or can be calculated by the formula base area multiplied by the length of the prism. Since the base is a triangle, so the base area will be the area of the triangle, that is half multiplied by base multiplied by height. So half multiplied by the base of the triangle is 5 and the height of the triangle is 4. So half multiplied by 4 multiplied by 5 multiply by the length of the prism. The length of the prism is equals to 7. So when we will multiply these 4, we will get an answer of 70. So the volume of this triangular prism is 70. The surface area can be calculated by the formula 2 times base area plus perimeter of base multiplied by the length of the prism. The length is given 7. The perimeter of base can be calculated by adding the three sides of the triangle, which are 7, 9 and 5. And the base area, since it is a triangle, so it can be calculated by the formula half into base into height. The base is 5, the height of the triangle is 4. And since we are multiplying it with half and there is a 2 outside, so 2 and 2 will be cancelled out and the base and the height will remain. So the formula here is written as base height. This is the same formula which we discussed in the previous slide. So the base and the height, which is 4 and 5, so 4 multiplied by 5 is 20, plus the perimeter of the base is the sum of the three sides of a triangle, 7 plus 9 plus 5 equals to 21, multiplied by the length of the prism, that is 7. So 21 multiplied by 7 is 147 and plus 20 will give us an answer of 167. The surface area of this triangular prism is 167 and the volume is 70. The next type of prism is a rectangular prism. This can also be called as a cuboid. The example of a rectangular prism is a tissue box or a shoe box. The volume of rectangular prism can be calculated by the formula length multiplied by width multiplied by height. This is the same formula which we use to find the volume of cuboid. The surface area, since it has 6 faces and the opposite faces of a rectangular prism are equal, so we are using 2 to indicate that the two identical sides are equal. So first we will pair length and width, then we will pair length and height, and then we will pair width and height, and all these three answers will be added and multiplied by 2 to get the surface area of a rectangular prism or cuboid. Since it has 6 faces, the opposite faces are equal, so we are multiplying it with 2 to indicate that the opposite faces are equal. So the volume can be calculated by the formula length multiplied by width multiplied by height, and the surface area can be calculated by the formula 2 times length multiplied by width plus length multiplied by height plus width multiplied by height. You can change the order of these three, it will give you the same answer. To find out the volume and surface area of a rectangular prism, we are discussing an example. We have a rectangular prism whose dimension is 10, 3 and 8. The length is 10 inch, the width is 3 inch and the height is 8 inch. The volume of rectangular prism can be calculated by the formula length multiplied by width multiplied by height, that is 10 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 8. That gives us an answer of 240 inch cube. Since all the dimensions are in inch, so the unit will be inch cube. And the total surface area of a rectangular prism, we will be using the same formula, 2 times length multiplied by width plus 2 times height multiplied by width plus 2 times length multiplied by height. This is the same formula which we discussed in the previous slide. You just have to put the value. The length is 10 and the width is 3. So 10 multiplied by 3 is 30 and 30 multiplied by 2 is 60. The height is 8 and the width is 3. 8 multiplied by 3 is 24, 24 times 2 is 48, plus the length is 10 and the height is 8. 10 multiplied by 8, 80, and multiplied by 2 will be 160. And when we will add 60 plus 48 plus 160, this will give us an answer of 268. Since all the dimensions are in inch, so it will be 268 inch square. We will be discussing only three types of prism. So this one is the last type of prism of this slide, and it is a cube or a square prism. A square prism can also be called as a cube, and the volume for the cube is calculated by the formula S cube. So the volume for the square prism is also the same, that is, the volume is equal to side multiplied by side multiplied by side, since all the sides are equal. So the volume is S cube. The surface area is 6S square, because a cube or a square prism has 6 identical sides and each side is a square. So the area of a square is side multiplied by side S square, and since it has 6 faces, so 6S square will be the surface area of the cube or square prism, and the volume will be S cube. The three types of prisms are over, so it's time for us to discuss about cylinder. Cylinder is basically a 3D solid, a 3D object that has two circular faces. One is at the top and one is at the bottom. And we have a curved surface of a cylinder. The net diagram is also drawn. There is a rectangle in between, which is the curved surface of the cylinder. And the other two circles, one is the top face and one is the bottom face. So it has two circles and a rectangle. The volume of cylinder can be calculated by the formula pi multiplied by r square multiplied by h. R is the radius of the cylinder and h is the height of the cylinder. And talking about the surface area, there are two types of surface area of a cylinder. The first one is the curved surface area, that can be calculated by the formula 2 pi r h. Since the curved surface area is basically the area of the rectangle, we will not include the two circles in it. So the curved surface area can be found out by the formula 2 pi r h. R is the radius and h is the height of the cylinder. And the total surface area of the cylinder will be calculated by the formula 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. 2 pi r h is the area of the rectangle, and 2 pi r square, you know that the area of one circle is pi r square, so we have two circles, so the total area will be 2 pi r square of two circles plus the area of the rectangle, that is 2 pi r h. So if you are interested in finding out the surface area of a cylinder that has a top and a base, you will be using the formula 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. For example, if the question says that your cylinder is open, means you don't have a top face, so you will be subtracting 1 pi r square from the formula. If you have an open cylinder, your formula will be pi r square plus 2 pi r h, because we have only one circle. So the volume is pi r square h, and the curved surface area 2 pi r h, and total surface area or the surface area of a cylinder can be found out by the formula 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. One example of finding out the volume and surface area of a cylinder: we have a cylinder whose radius is 4 cm and the height of the cylinder is 9 cm. We have to find out the volume and surface area of this cylinder. The volume of cylinder can be found out by the formula pi r square h. So the value of pi is 3.142 multiplied by, the radius is 4, so 4 square multiplied by the height of the cylinder, that is 9. The volume of cylinder of radius 4 cm and height 9 is equal to 452.448. Since all the units are in centimeter, so the unit will be centimeter cube. The surface area, since this cylinder has a top and a bottom, so we will be using the formula 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. The radius is 4, 2 times 3.142 multiplied by 4 square plus 2 pi r h, 2 times 3.142 multiplied by 4 multiplied by the height of the cylinder, which is 9. And on solving these two numbers, we will get a surface area of 326.56 centimeter square. Since this cylinder has a top and a bottom as well, so we have used this formula 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. The volume of the cylinder has only one formula, that is pi r square h. The volume of this cylinder is 452.448 centimeter cube, and the surface area is 326.56 centimeter cube. It's time for your practice now. You have an example question, just write the solution, pause this video and solve the question by yourself, and then see is your answers correct. Have you done it correctly? Have you solved it correctly? The question is, we have a triangular prism and the length of the prism is given to us, that is 15 centimeter. The dimensions of the base is also given. The three sides of a triangle, that is the base, are 5, 5 and 4. The height of the triangle is 3 cm. So first of all, we are asked to find the volume and surface area. So we will move on with volume. The volume of a triangular prism can be given by the formula base area multiplied by the length of the prism. Base area means the area of the triangle. The area of the triangle can be given by the formula half multiplied by base multiplied by height. The base is 4 and the height is 3 and the length of the prism is 15. So we will multiply half, 4, 3 and 15, and we will get an answer of 90 centimeter cube, since the dimensions are in centimeter. For surface area, the formula is 2 times base area plus perimeter of the base multiplied by the length of the prism. Base area, since it is a triangle, so half multiplied by base multiplied by height. 2 is outside and half is inside. Half multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 will give us an answer of 6. And then we will multiply it with 2 and we will get 12, plus the three dimensions of the base, 5 plus 5 plus 4 is equals to 14, and when 14 will be multiplied with the length of prism, that is 15, the answer will be 210, and when we will add 210 and 12, we will get an answer of 222 centimeter square. So the volume of this prism is 90 centimeter cube and the surface area is 222 centimeter square. I hope you have also got the same answer. Check your solutions. One example question on a rectangular prism. A rectangular prism is given to us. The length is 3 centimeter, the width is 2 centimeter and the height is 6 centimeter. And we have to find the volume and surface area of this rectangular prism. The volume can be calculated by the formula length multiplied by width multiplied by height. 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 6 will give us an answer of 36 centimeter cube, since the all dimensions in centimeter and it is volume, so centimeter cube will be the unit. The total surface area is given by the formula 2 times length multiplied by width plus length multiplied by height plus width multiplied by height, and by putting the values, length is 3 and width is 2, so 3 multiplied by 2 plus length is 3 and height is 6, 3 multiplied by 6 plus width is 2 and height is 6, 2 multiplied by 6, 3 times 2 is 6, 3 times 6 is 18, 2 times 6 is 12, on adding 6, 18 and 12 we will get 36, 36 when multiplied by 2 will give us an answer of 72 centimeter square, which is the surface area of this rectangular prism. you can change the order of the pairs you can in the formula for the surface area. You can write length into height first, and it depends upon you how you pair up this. So the volume of this rectangular prism is 36 cm cube and the surface area is 72 cm square. One last question on the volume and surface area of a cylinder. We have a cylinder whose radius is 10 cm and the height is 25 cm. And we are asked to find the surface area and volume of this cylinder. This cylinder has basically both a top and a base. So there are two circles and a curved surface area. So the formula is 2 pi r square plus 2 pi rh. And the volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. The solution is not complete. There is an error in the solution, and I want you guys to have a look at it and tell me the error. Where is the error in the solution? Are the answers correct? If they are not correct, then what is the problem with the answers? You can tell me your suggestions, your answers in the comment box, so that I can be able to identify the error and correct this question. So that's all for now. I will be waiting for your responses for the last question. I hope you guys can help me in finding out the error. Thank you very much for visiting. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. I hope this presentation has helped you in refreshing your concepts. And after watching this presentation, you are now sure about how to find the volume and total surface area of prisms and cylinders. So I will be waiting for your feedback. Do give me the feedback in the comment box, because your feedback is a motivation for me and it helps me in getting things better and it helps me in improving my skills. So do give me the feedback. I will be waiting, and thank you very much for visiting and watching this. I will be back with some more videos inshallah soon, and until then, I am your host FTG. Goodbye, Allah Hafiz, stay safe.